Listen to these folks in Chicago.
Reality is, it's gotta say no, because that's the simple solution is no. Turn the buses around.
We come in a community of black people where we already get the low scraps. And then you want to take the little scraps, the resources that we have, and put us at the bottom of the barrel?
Voters in big blue cities like Chicago are absolutely revolting over the migrant crisis, and it is likely what is persuading the Biden administration, if you ask me, to do a pretty big 180 in regard to the construction of Trump's border wall, something that Biden on the debate stage swore that he would not do, something that he swore he would end on day one of his administration. Well, turns out no, he is going to use congressionally appropriated funds in order to continue the construction on Trump's border wall. Now, in order to do that, the federal government needs to waive quite a few laws. In fact, more than 24 laws pertaining to the environment, and they're gonna go ahead and do that. So let me give you the details on what's happening. I'll give you the details on what the Biden administration is alleging is going on. We can question whether we believe them. But in a public notice posted Wednesday, the Department of Homeland Security outlined its intent to build up to 20 new miles of Trump administration era border barriers in the Rio Grande Valley of Texas, one of the busiest crossing spots for migrants attempting to enter the United States. Now, apparently, again, this goes against what Biden said he was gonna do, but there is in fact a giant flow of migrants coming into the country. Many of these people are now being bused to blue cities. And for the first time, you have Democratic lawmakers and Democratic constituents complaining about the migrant crisis. So this is no longer a Republican versus Democrat issue. And I actually think that's a good thing, mostly because I think Congress absolutely needs to act on comprehensive immigration reform. If one party is concerned about immigration and another party is pretending like it's not a problem at all, you're less likely to get any legislation passed through, and we desperately need it. There is presently an acute and immediate need to construct physical barriers and roads in the vicinity of the border of the United States in order to prevent unlawful entries into the United States in these project areas, the notice reads. So again, this is the notice from the Department of Homeland Security. I think it's important for you to know what it said as you hear Biden's explanation in just a moment. It added that the administration will waive federal, state, and local laws that protect water, air, and endangered species to speed up the construction. Now, illegal border crossings have surpassed 2 million for each of the last 2 years. The administration had halted all construction on Trump's border wall the first day of the Biden presidency. But Biden had an interesting answer to a question that was asked of him today. I want to go to that video and see if we are buying what he's selling.
On the border wall. The border wall, the money was appropriated for the border wall. I tried to get them to reappropriate, to redirect that money. They didn't, they wouldn't. And in the meantime, there's nothing under the law other than they have to use the money for what it was appropriated. I can't stop that.
Do you believe the border wall works?
No.
So he's saying that he does not believe the border wall works, but he is forced to use this money that was appropriated by Congress back in 2019, specifically to build the border wall. So what are your thoughts, Cenk?
Not Biden.
Same.
Okay, so they, look, unfortunately, a lot of Democratic voters are gullible on stuff like this. So they say, well, there was a law passed in 2019, that's true, okay? And we tried to reappropriate the money, it's relatively true, okay? And so now there's nothing we can do, not at all true. Okay, so they've been delaying it this whole time. They could continue delaying it. They don't have to take an executive branch action to waive all those environmental laws, etc. right now. They're doing it right now. There's no, like, there's no court order. There's no date that they ran into. No, they're doing it now because of the pressure from Republicans to do something about the border. But it's not just pressure from Republicans, as Democrats. Anna pointed out. It's Hochul in New York, Pritzker in Illinois, and Adams, the mayor of New York City, etc. So this pressure is mounting, and there, and even fellow Democrats are saying you got to do something about it because it's going to cost me my elections locally, etc. So don't insult our intelligence by pretending that you had to do it this minute. You're doing it because of the pressure. And so you're giving in to Trump and you're building more wall. And that's pretty disastrous. Okay, now, if Biden had decided, I don't think the wall works, okay, like me personally. But let's say that Biden disagrees with me and decided that the wall does work, he's gonna change his mind on it, etc. Okay, all right, but do that when you think it makes sense. And you know, if when your Department of Homeland Security calls for it, which apparently they're now claiming they called for it 6 months ago, right? So, but when you do it, when it looks like appeasement of Republicans, oh, that's a disaster. Because then you look super weak, and appeasement of Republicans never works. They always want more, they never ever give you credit. And of course, immediately afterwards, every Republican, including Donald Trump, went,
Yeah, look, I honestly don't think he's doing it to appease Republicans at all. I think he's doing it because of the pure rage that typical Democratic voters are feeling in these cities that are honestly dealing with a massive influx of migrants, and they don't have anywhere to shelter them. There aren't jobs for them. Well, it is a big problem.
So no, you're right about that. But then I make 2 points about that. One is, okay, well, Biden, what do you think works in stopping the flow of undocumented immigrants? So do you think it's the wall, or do you think it's something else? Because everybody thinks you should stop the flow of undocumented immigrants. It's not, I mean, I hope Democrats don't think like, oh, it's okay, we shouldn't have a border. I mean, some radical folks said that in like 2020 campaign, but Biden wasn't among them. I'm not among them. So then why don't you do the thing that you think will actually work?
Yes.
So that there'll be less undocumented immigrants and there'll be less rage here.
Can I jump
in? And then I have a second point in a second, but go
ahead.
Yeah,
no, I actually think, at least the portion of the left that I've heard on this issue has some real immediate solutions, although I do believe that there needs to be real comprehensive immigration reform. However, the majority of migrants who are coming to the border right now are Venezuelans, okay? Mm-hmm. There are also Cubans coming to the border looking to come in. Lift the sanctions. Okay, the sanctions are crushing people in Venezuela. So improve the conditions in those countries so these people don't feel forced to flee for economic opportunities. And I really do think that's the case with Venezuela and Cuba.
And by the way, the Cubans and the Venezuelans have extra privileges in being able to come in, and partly because the Republicans wanted it. So let's make up our minds. Do we want them or don't we want them?
So look, guys, it's, as with every issue, this is a complicated issue because of course you want to approach it from a place of empathy. You want to, it's a humanitarian crisis. This is not a small thing, but it's also very complex, right? So I didn't know this until today. I've been, you know, looking into, you know, all the various players behind the scenes who are in Biden's ear. Apparently, a group of CEOs represented by the Chamber of Commerce had sent a letter to Biden earlier this year urging him to fast track the workers' visas, okay? Mm-hmm. Or the temporary worker visas for the migrants.
Oh, I know why, okay.
So behind the scenes, and this isn't being talked about enough, I think Li Fong is the only person, only reporter I've heard cover this or talk about this. There is this tension between labor groups and the Chamber of Commerce, because the Chamber of Commerce and the businesses it represents hates the fact that workers for the first time in a long time have some leverage due to the tight labor market.
Yeah, so look, I'm in a couple of different circles, politics, media, but also business. So in the business articles that I read, there's nonstop talk of, oh, I hope unemployment goes up. Why? It seems weirdly cruel, right? Now they're thinking, they have to keep their labor costs lower, and they're getting punished in the markets because of it in their mind. And so when there is low unemployment, the labor market is tighter and it drives up wages, right? Mm-hmm. So since they can't help the fact that the unemployment situation is actually fantastic for the rest of us, they're trying to bring in cheaper undocumented immigrants so that they could lower their labor costs, right? Or documented.
In this case, it would be documented.
Yeah, in documented is better for them, because then they don't have to worry about anything going wrong. And the Venezuelans, they're fleeing socialism, perfect, right? So they're gonna bring in cheap labor, and that's why the Chamber of Commerce wants it.
Yes.
So, and that's what's driving a lot of this. But no, but does Biden out the Chamber of Commerce? No way. Because he also takes money from those corporate interests. By the way, does Donald Trump out Chamber of Commerce? No way.
No. But by the way, at the same time, further complicating the matter, you have the governor of New York, Hochul, demanding that Biden fast track the worker visas, specifically because of the fact that, you know, in New York City right now, they're really struggling with the lack of resources, and they want to get these migrants independent, able to earn on their own, so they're not relying so heavily on the social safety net in that state. And so I understand that perspective as well. But look, at the root of this, in my opinion, is the lack of comprehensive immigration reform, which would allocate the necessary funding for more immigration judges to just deal with the massive backlog of individuals seeking asylum. And also on top of that, there's just this need to basically do away with these sanctions that might be desired by people who are super salty about what happened with the Cuban Revolution, or super salty about, you know, socialism in Venezuela. But listen, improve the conditions in those countries, which creates an incentive for people to remain in their countries. It makes more sense.
100%, but our politicians are just not that fast, that forward thing. Okay, last points here. Look, guys, I hate to say I told you so, but when Greg Abbott started busing immigrants to Democratic cities, I said that's a really good idea on his part, because it's gonna spread the pain to the blue states, and they're gonna feel the pain, and then they're gonna react. And that's exactly what happened, okay? I wish I wasn't right about that, but that, you know, you can go back to the very first day when I made that comment, because to me, this was fairly obvious. And by the way, not fair, as I've said all along, to the border states, that they should deal with all the pain without anybody else chipping in. And finally, look, no matter what you think is the right approach for immigration, Biden caving in, and all the Democrats, not just Biden, caving in and building more wall as if that'll work. Oh, it's terrible optics, terrible politics. From here on out, every Republican will say for eternity, we told you the walls work. Trump was right in building a wall. You guys all complained for no reason at all.
Yep.
Ha ha. So it is incredible weakness on the part of the Democrats to go in this direction.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.